All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios. And joining us in studio is our energy market analyst from the Oil and Gas Investment Bulletin, Keith Schaefer. Keith, nice to have you back in the studio. How are you?
Steve, doing well. Thanks for having me.
You know, we're hearing a lot about oil and oil prices and what's been happening in Alberta and oil. We haven't heard a lot about liquefied natural gas in the LNG market in British Columbia and Canada and around the world. So let's talk a little bit about LNG. Talk about prices. Where are they right now?
Sure. You know, internationally, prices have done much better than everyone expected. There is a huge new supply source in Australia that came on this year, and everyone thought prices would fall, but they've stayed very strong because of Asia. Mm-hmm. Natural gas is the clean fossil fuel, and Chinese imports have stayed incredibly strong. They're up about 40%. And so international prices are doing great, which is a big contrast to Canadian prices, which are basically the lowest in the Western world.
Right. So there's a big difference between those two.
What
is that going to eventually close, do you think?
Well, I hope so for our economy's sake, but I think things are actually happening there. And that's a bit of an interesting story because what we're seeing now, two pretty large LNG groups come back to Canada and really, they see that big gap and saying, wow, that's a big profit to be made.
Right.
And so we're seeing two groups now start to get involved in Canadian LNG.
We'll talk about those two groups in a second, but I want to ask you a little bit about Canada in general. We know there's a lot of LNG prospects here in British Columbia, elsewhere in Canada as well?
Mm-hmm. Well, yes and no. Almost everything is being done here on the West Coast, except for a group called Pieridae out of Nova Scotia. They've got a supply arrangement that they're putting together to ship LNG over to Europe and India, actually.
Okay. Interesting. So let's talk about these two companies that you mentioned that are they ramping up work? What's happening with these two companies? We're talking about Chevron and Shell, right?
Yeah, Shell and Chevron. Shell is probably the farthest ahead, but Chevron is really moving ahead quite quickly as well. And to me, Steve, the big thing here is that they're doing it way more stealthily and quietly than we've ever seen any other mega project go forward. Mm-hmm. We're talking about a 2 billion cubic feet a day facility, or maybe even 3 or 4 billion cubic feet a day, that would cost like $40 billion. That's a big number.
Yeah.
And what we're seeing now is all the construction prep is getting done, all the environmental permits are getting done, we're seeing equipment on site in Kitimat, British Columbia, big yellow trucks with the wrapping still on, and no news. No press releases, no news. Mm-hmm. Everything's being very, very quiet. It's actually really surprising that we're seeing no news out of any of these companies, mm-hmm. and yet they've hired their major contractor, so they know which global group is going to get that $40 billion in CapEx.
Right.
They've hired the beds out, the man camp facilities, so they're doing all these things kind of under investors and the public's radar right now.
Why do you think that is?
Well, there's never been a mega project in Canada that hasn't had 100 protesters on it. So
right.
I think industry is finally getting the message that if they're going to bring Canada some prosperity, they've got to do it very quietly and not attract attention so that by the time they actually do say, okay, we're ready to go here. Oh, and by the way, we've already hired everybody. Everyone's coming in shortly and, you know, the money's going to get spent immediately.
Right.
So where it's really going to be too late for anybody to do or say anything on how it gets approved.
Are they almost in a best case scenario right now just because of there's so many other things going on that's taking the media's attention away from what they're doing? I mean, it couldn't be a better time for a mega project to be operating stealth when there's so many other things to talk about.
Oh, I think Shell and Chevron are so grateful for Kinder Morgan right now. They yeah. are, Kinder Morgan and that oil terminal in Burnaby is taking all the protest, all the activity and interest from the environmental movement to their place and leaving everything in Kitimat and Prince Rupert totally empty just to get simple business done.
Now here at Proactive Investors, of course, we talk a lot about the junior companies, and what will this mean for the junior companies, that the progress that you see these two companies make? Is that good news for them?
Oh yeah, it's going to be fantastic news for the juniors, but not right away.
Okay.
So what it will do is it will bring a lot of market interest back to Canada, and people are going to see how ridiculously undervalued a lot of these juniors are. At the same time, none of these big facilities are going to be ready until 2023.
Okay.
So it's still a few more years of relatively low pricing, but that'll start showing up in Canadian pricing in only a couple of years from now, because there will be another tug pull away from the American market, which is where all our exports go. So we'll start to see that even within a couple of years, Canadian prices start to pick up and price in this new LNG demand.
Keith, thanks very much. That's Keith Schaefer, our energy market analyst with the Oil and Gas Investment Bulletin here on Proactive Investors.